שלום וברכה, אודת wish to all of you, ברכה והצלחה. The parashat Ekev, the Torah talk about the small mitzvot that we have to be very careful to do them. In general, mitzvot that we are not used to do all year, so when they come, we do them at the perfection, like Pesach. Pesach, it's one in a year. So Pesach, we do it well, because it's Pesach. Sukkot, the same. Rosh Hashanah, the same. Sukkot, the same. Hanukkah, the same. Purim, the same. Even to be Shabbat, it's only a custom, we do it well, with all the fruit that we buy. But let's see, to wash the hand before you eat. We do that all day. So we are used to do it, having a yarmulke in the head. Sometimes it fails, and we carry on walking without the yarmulke. Because it's a mitzvah that we got used to it. Put it filling every day. It's a mitzvah that we do every day. So it's not a big deal for us, God forbid. So that's what the Torah said. You have to be very careful with this small mitzvot. And that the small mitzvot, you have to do well, to do them in the perfection. You know, the Torah, it didn't give us the price of the reward of a mitzvah that you do. There is a mitzvah of Shemitah. Wow, the mitzvah of Shemitah, it's a big mitzvah. Okay, imagine, for 1 year in Israel, you don't touch your land. You lose millions of dollars. The mitzvah of Shemitah. And you have, what is the reward of this mitzvah if you do it? We don't know. What about the mitzvah that you have a yarmulke in your head every minute? You don't know. Probably after 120 years, they will show you that the small mitzvot that you do, you get more reward on them than the big mitzvot that you do. And that will be a big surprise. So that's what the Torah said, V'haya ekif shishmeon. If you do those mitzvot, the small mitzvot, if you do them well and with joy, so you get the bracha. Can you imagine? Hashem give you the bracha not for the big things, He give you the bracha for the small things. And I would like to tell you a beautiful story that it happened this week. This week I was receiving people, and there was a lady that she came from for a bracha. And this lady, it seemed to me, through her name, that she's a convert woman. Her name is X Bat Avraham Avinu. Automatically, when you hear the name of somebody, Ben Avraham, Bat Avraham Avinu, and so on. So I told her, Bat Sarah as well? Yes. So you are covered? She said yes. So I told her, Madam, where are you from? Because she had a perfect English. She said, I am from New York, but I live here. I live here in Montreal. So I told her, can you tell me why did you convert? I want to know. She told me, when I was a baby in New York, I was with my parents, and they saw a man with strings around his body. And I told my mother, what's this? She told me, he's Jewish. And what he's wearing, it's a religious clothes. And she started crying. So I told my mother, why you cry? So she told me, because my origin, my grandfather, he was Jew. His name was Mr. Medina. But he got married to a non-Jew, so we are not Jew. But my grandfather was Jew. So the woman told me, I told my mother, Mama, I am now 12 years old. Yes, yes, why? Because one day I want to become like them. I belong to those people with the string. And since then, she began to have more interest in the Jewish religion, and she converted herself with nobody that pushed her. And I told her, why you don't live in New York? Why you live here? She said, here I give good chinuch, good education, to my children. If I go to New York with the family there, maybe I will lose the education. Honest, there I could live easily, better, finance, it could be good for me. But here, spiritual, it's better. So look what a sacrifice that lady did. Become Jew, to live with less money, and the most important, that she discovered religion. You know, who made her discover religion? The Talit. But the Talit, we wear it all the time. And how come that the Talit doesn't help us to become Jew, to become a better Jew? The Torah said, "Or item oto, uschartem et komitzvot Hashem asitet otam." The Torah said, when you look at the mitzvot of the Talit, you remember that Hashem gives you mitzvot, and you do them. So how come that we have a Talit, we look at the Talit, and it doesn't affect us to do more mitzvot? How come? Because we got used to it. And that's what the Torah said. V'haya ekev tishmeon. Be careful of the mitzvot that you are used to do, because you are used to do them, so maybe you will not do them in the perfection. This Goya, she saw the Talit and she become Jew. We saw the Talit and we remain the same. Unfortunately. It's incredible. I would like to tell you, somebody this week told me a beautiful story about my grandfather, Rabbi Chaim Pinto, alav shalom. He told me that one day Rabbi Chaim Pinto, he went outside the city of Issawira with a name named Ben Ezra. And he told him, there is some people that they're coming from London, already 3 months on their trip, and they have a donation for me. So let's go to welcome them, because I need the money for tzedakah. So they went, and then Ben Ezra told Rabbi Chaim Pinto, "Rabbi, I'm thirsty, I want to drink." He told him, "Oh, look, I don't have water for you. I don't want to make a miracle for water. You can resist. At least 15 minutes. Those people, they will arrive. Probably they have water. They will give you water." And Rabbi Chaim Pinto told him, "Do you see something coming? A coach coming?" "No, I don't see nothing." "Then, yes, I see a shadow of something." "Oh, it's them." And they arrive. They saw Rabbi Chaim Pinto. They came out from their coach and they kissed the hand of Rabbi Chaim Pinto and they give him the money. And Rabbi Chaim Pinto told them, "It's from England." They said, "Yes, it's from England." "Do you have water for Ben Ezra?" "Yes, we have plenty of water, food, everything." So Rabbi Chaim Pinto said to Ezra, "Go, drink, eat, and then let's go back." When I heard this story, I said to myself, this man, Ben Ezra, alav shalom, he saw that kind of miracle. He saw that Rabbi Chaim Pinto was a prophet. At that time, there was no telephones, no texto, no computer, nothing to telecommunication. There was nothing. How did Rabbi Chaim Pinto know all this? And he saw people are coming from London with money. And even he said the amount of money and water. Did this Ben Ezra change? I mean, if you see those kind of miracles from a tzaddik, you change your way of life. You become a tzaddik too. He didn't change. He remained the same. You know why? Because he used to see Rabbi Chaim Pinto doing miracles. It's like every morning I wake up. I want to tell you my own story. I went to bed last night at 1 o'clock at night. And I said to myself, "Hashem, help me to wake up at 3 o'clock. I want to pray." I woke up exactly at 3 o'clock. I prayed for somebody. And then I said, "Now I want to sleep till 6 o'clock. But I couldn't sleep. It was too late. Il sait qu'un message, hey, formation, David, I've been waiting for you to wake you up, now go and study Torah. You didn't need to go to bed again. So you see, in our life, we have to live. You know, we should not see Hashem always small. We should every day see Hashem bigger and bigger and bigger. Yeah, you become bigger on money. You become bigger on age. So you have to see Hashem bigger as two. Not only at your confidence, as your confidence, you see Hashem big. You have to see Hashem big when you are in good shape and when you are in bad shape. Yeah? Hashem should be the same, and to see him always more and more and more and more. And this is the parasha of Ve'ayah Ekev Tishmeon. This is the most important, that Ve'ayah Ekev Tishmeon. Look, David HaMelech Alav HaShalom, one day he came to the Beit HaMikdash and he said, Hashem, Ahad Sha'alti Me'et Hashem Ota Habakesh. שבתי בבית השם כל מחיי לחזות בנועם השם ולבקר ביחלו. דוד המלך, עליו השלום, יסד השם, I want to ask you one thing, not two things. Every time that I come to the בית המקדש, I want to feel like if this is the first time that I came to בית המקדש. I don't want to get used to it. דוד המלך, עליו השלום, you know, this מזמור, לדוד אדוני אורי וישעי ממהרה. This מזמור of Tehillim of David HaMelech, we say it all the month of Elul till after Kippur. Every day. During 40 days we read it. Why? Unfortunately, every year we do Rosh Hashanah. And we pray. Did we change? Since last year, every year we have Kippur. Did we change? Did it change? I mean, this is what David HaMelech is singing. I mean, it's not fair that every year you come, you are judged, Rosh Hashanah Hashem judged you, then he forgive you, and you remain the same. You get used to it. Do you get used to Rosh Hashanah and Kippur? No, you have to improve yourself. What it is Rosh Hashanah about? Improving. Hashem, anyway, will forgive you. But you have to improve yourself. If you don't improve yourself, what do you win? You know what to tell you something incredible. There is a man who asked me a beautiful question. He said, Rabbi, what is the difference between Paro and Bil'am? Paro, he became that when after he saw all the miracles, he did Teshuvah. He said, Mi kamucha ba'elim Hashem. And Bil'am, he was a big prophet, he was a Rasha. He said, I want to live like a Jew, and I want No, I want to live as I want, and I want to die like a Jew, and I want to have Gan Eden. I mean, it's crazy to have Gan Eden, and to die like a Jew. You have to live like a Jew. And he was a prophet, he spoke to Hashem. He blessed the Bnei Israel, he said, Matuvo Alecha Yaakov. He was more prophet than Moshe Rabbeinu. And what happened? Why he was Rasha? Why? And he was Baal Gaava, he was very snob, arrogant. And besides this, he wanted to curse the Jews. But if you curse the Jews, they will die. If they die, who will study the Torah? So that means you are a kamikaze. If there is nobody who studied Torah, Hashem will destroy the world. And if he destroys the world, you Bil'am, you die. He don't care. He hated so much the Jews. The Gemara Gittin said that Titus, it was a witchcraft, and he bring the Bil'am from Gehinnom, and he asked him, can you tell me, Bil'am, how in the Shamayim the Jewish people are considered? He told him, Titus, you want to destroy the temple? Destroy it, kill the Jews, and don't ask about their life. Just kill them. Bil'am, he is in Gan Eden. He see the Emet. And even there, he don't change. I mean, once you see the Emet, that's it. So, you know what is my answer? My answer is that there is a difference between one who is poor man and he work hard to become rich. That's somebody who win the lotto. The one who was poor and he work hard to become rich, he appreciate the money. But a one who was poor and he won the lotto, he came just like, so he can lose it the same way he win it. He cannot, the money is not so important in his eyes. Because he won it, he win it without working. Parao, to reach the level that he, when he said, Mi kamu chabal eviv Hashem, because he saw the greatness of Hashem. Hashem, he hit him. And Parao, he compared himself to God. And Parao, at the end, he realized that there is only Hashem. To realize who is Hashem, it's a work. Understand? Ma Hashem dorish me'emcha ki im ne'ra. Everything HaKadosh Baruch Hu can help you. He can give you money, he can give you anything you want. Except one thing, he will not give it to you. To fear Hashem, he will not give it to you. To fear Hashem, it's your work. There is a woman walking. No one can help you not to look at her. You have to help yourself. But if you have a big etzara, so Hashem can help you. But always, in your atchamayim, to fear Hashem, you have to start first. Then Hashem will help you. Well, Paro, he wanted to fear Hashem. He couldn't. But he worked hard to fear Hashem. At the end, he reached the level, Mi kamucha ba'elim Hashem. Bil'am, he didn't want to work for himself. He became prophet with nothing. He was a rasha. He had a relationship with his donkey. Yes. The Gemara said that he has relationship with his donkey. He's a big rasha. Big rasha. And he was a prophet. How you imagine this? Well, Hashem had no choice. He made him to be a prophet so that the goyim, they will not say, what the Jewish people they have, Moshe, and we don't have nobody. So Hashem said, okay, I give you Bil'am. So Bil'am, instead of using the prophecy that he got free with nowhere from Hashem to improve himself, to become better man, he remained worse and worse and worse. So as you know, that's the difference between Paro and Bil'am. You know what the Gemara said? The Gemara said that the Rasha'im, even at the door of Gehinnom, they don't do Teshuvah. Because the Teshuvah can do it only here, in this world. There is no Teshuvah there. So because Bil'am died Rasha, he remained Rasha up there. You know, Mashiach is going to come Be'ezat Hashem. People don't believe too much what's going to happen. But they should be warned. We warn them that when they see Mashiach coming, it's too late for them to do Teshuvah. Teshuvah is before Mashiach comes, not after Mashiach comes. After that Mashiach comes, there is no Teshuvah. It's too late. Too late. It's, you know, of course, the story of Ankelos. The beautiful story of Ankelos. Ankelos, he was a goy. And he realized, he started to see how much the Jewish people suffered. All generations he suffered. And always Am Yisrael Hai. He did not understand why nobody finished with them. Not the Greek, not the Romans, not the Egyptian, not Babylon. Why? So he started to think there is something who keep them. I don't want to tell you who told me this. There is a king, a big king, who told me the reason why I respect the Jewish people and I do all my best to protect them and to be approached to them, because I saw that no nation during 4,000 years of the Jewish history, no one, people hit them, but no one destroyed them. That means there is God. That means there is God who protects them. And besides, they are tzaddikim. There is tzaddikim. They are good people. They respect their Torah. They respect their Shabbat. Who can respect Shabbat? Even Jewish people that they are not so religious, they respect Shabbat. They respect Pesach. It's not easy. It's very expensive to do all this. So I realized that the Jewish religion, it's honest. So I told him, so why you not become Jew? You know what he told me? He said, I respect the Judaism, but I was born the way I was born. But the most important is I believe in God. So I told him, well, I'm proud of you because you respect the seven mitzvot of Bnei Noah. When you respect the seven mitzvot of Bnei Noah, among the seven mitzvot of Bnei Noah, it's to believe there is Hashem. And don't kill, don't do bad things. You do all this. So, after 120 years, you will have Olam Haba. And Ankelos, he was the nephew of Adrianus. Adrianus has no children. If Adrianus die, Ankelos, he would take over, he become the emperor of Rome. But he was already in the middle of searching about the Judaism. So he went to discover. And he stayed in Israel many years. He converted himself, he started to study Torah. And he became prophet. Can you imagine what's this? A goy who became prophet. And he explained the whole Torah with prophecy. It's incredible. Today, it's a mitzvah to read. Shnei Mikra v'Echad Targum. Can you imagine? We compare the Targum like the Torah. Every Shabbat, we have to read twice the Torah and once the Targum. Do you do it? Good. So, Adrianus, he sent him some people to bring him back to Rome. And after conversation with those people, he convinced him that God is the Emet, and they convert themselves. Adrianus, at the end, he saw that Ankelos, he didn't want to come, so he sent him some strong people, and he told them, when you see Ankelos, don't have a conversation with him, because he may convince you to become Jew. Just shut his mouth and bring him. That's what they did. And then Ankelos, he told them, please do me a favor, I forgot something in the house. And he went to the house and he kissed the mezuzah. So they asked him, What do you do? He said, well, I kissed my protector. What do you mean? This is the mezuzah. Usually, the king, he is in his palace, and the bodyguards are outside the palace to protect him. With us, it's the contrary. God, Hashem, he is the king, he is outside. We are the slaves, we are inside, and it's the king who protects the Jews. The Shaddai, the name of the mezuzah is Shaddai. Shomer Datot Israel. Hashem protects the doors of Am Israel. When they heard that, they become Jew. So a lot of rabbis ask a question. We don't understand. So why we don't use that kind of argument to bring people to teshuvah? If Ankelos, he convinced those Roman to convert themselves only by kissing the mezuzah, so it's an easy idea. So we kiss the mezuzah, people will ask us, what do you do? Well, you know, usually the king, he is inside and the bodyguard outside to protect him, and we are inside and the king is outside to protect us. We do that all the time, but nobody do teshuvah. The answer is, unfortunately, we got used to kiss the mezuzah. We kiss the mezuzah without thinking. Just like a habit. But if Behemet we kiss the mezuzah with all the thoughts that we need, if we take the talit, we kiss it with all the thoughts that it means, we do teshuvah. The talit can remind you the mitzvot that Hashem give you and you will do them. But we do it as a habit. We kiss the mezuzah as a habit. But if Behemet we kiss the mezuzah like with a kavanah, with thought, with thinking, that could put people to do teshuvah. You know, there was an Israeli minister. He went to Spain and he was invited by the king of Spain, and he told him, I want to show you something in my palace. So the Israeli minister, I think it was the ambassador, I don't know, I can't tell, but it's a very famous story. So they went to the palace, and they showed him a beautiful picture of a man putting tefillin. And the Israeli minister or ambassador, he said to the king, he's a Jew with the tefillin. He said, yes. And the king told him, you know, how old is he? Is it spent? Since the Inquisition, since the Jewish people left Spain 700 years ago. So the Israeli minister, he asked the king, what? That means that Jewish people used to put tefillin 700 years ago as well? So he told him, why you don't know? Yes, they do it today as well. Your religion is not only now, your religion is the most old religion of all religions. Unfortunately, we see people with tefillin, it's become a habit, people. But when you see a picture of 700 years ago, a pen with tefillin, that gives you to ask a question. What? 700 years Jewish put tefillin? Not only 700 years, 2000, about three, since the Matan Torah we put tefillin. Till now. It just, unfortunately, we put them as a hobbit. We have to put them as a religion, and we will feel them. I pray to Hashem to give you bracha v'atzlacha, and b'riut amen k'ratzon.